Simon, there was another strike today. Please put us into the picture. How does this fit into the bigger scheme of things? Because there were one or two the other day as well from somewhere.
Johan, this strike started on Friday. The one that you saw today, it's related to the one that started on Friday. Actually, we were here, then we saw members of SAMHO coming in here, and they wanted to see the municipal manager. However, the municipal manager is on leave, and then they wanted to see the acting municipal manager. The acting municipal manager saw them, and then they handed over a memorandum to him. And in the memorandum, they were demanding that a suspended employee, there's an employee that has been suspended, that he be immediately be retained to work. And they are saying because as an employer we did not follow proper procedures to
And you guys say you have done so.
confidently, so we have followed all the necessary.
Now, Simon, is it only one person? Is that the chairperson of SAMHO down here, or a very senior guy?
Yes, he is the chairperson of SAMHO, but he's not suspended because he's the chairperson of SAMHO. He is suspended because of misconduct as an employee. Yeah, as an employee from Department of Economic Development and Planning, is suspended because of a misconduct as an employee.
Now, sorry for the interruption. Does this misconduct, does it have anything to do with the previous strike?
I wouldn't say because he has not been served with charges, because this suspension is a precautionary suspension. So I won't talk about the charges up until the charges are served to him formally.
So actually, we have two cases here. The one is the unhappiness about the merging and the fear that they will lose jobs. That was handled 10 days ago.
Yes.
So this one is a new one, and now where do we stand with this, and what's going to happen now?
Yes, there's one, you're correct. There's one that took place on the 8th of December. We're noting that one, and we're working on that one in terms of it, one being illegal, and also in terms of no work, no pay. That one, the one on the 8th. And the same goes with the one on Friday, the 18th. It was also an illegal strike, and it continued today as an illegal strike. We will definitely process the issue of no work, no pay, but also today we have served some leadership. We have informed some leadership of the ultimatum. We have served them with the letters of ultimatum that all those who are involved in the strike must return to work by 7:30 tomorrow, the 22nd of December, because they are on unprotected strike, and failure to return to their workplace and resume their duties may lead to dismissal. But I need to also indicate that even if they return to work by tomorrow, it does not mean that we will not implement the no work, no pay, and we will not maybe institute disciplinary processes, because embarking on an illegal strike is a misconduct
Well,
in
yes, but
by
how many
itself.
people are involved in the strike?
There are even less than 10%
Okay,
of
so
the
you see, why I
employees.
ask is, what about service delivery? Is it being affected?
It's not affected. Maybe whereby it is affected, it can be affected very little or minor inconveniences, because also when it started on Friday, the most areas that we realized that they were affected are the beaches, because ablution facilities were closed. Then we quickly, acted and made sure that we have a service provider, and all ablution facilities were opened. So nothing, actually, everything, is going as it's supposed to.
Simon, thank you very much for your time. Thanks for the information.
Thank you.